Working with the Managed File Transfer Design Tool. The Managed File Transfer product has three sections: design, monitoring, and administration. In our related demo, working with Managed File Transfer SOA 12C, we showed you how to monitor a file transfer. This demo will show you how to design and set up a managed file transfer. To get started, click the Design tab. In the left navigation, click Transfers. Enter name and then click Create. A palette appears. Now that the transfer is created, we can set parameters for this transfer. Let's start by creating a new source coming from the embedded FTP server. First, we'll name the source. The dropdown lets us choose the types that are available, and there are various web-based protocols, B2B protocols, and even remote sources available. For this demo, we will select FTP embedded. Enter the path or choose the Browse button to select the path. So now we have just completed an inbound source. Next, we will define what types of files we will be receiving. Here is a choice of files. Let's enter *.zip. With this option, we can put files in the folder on the FTP server, and the transfer will pick up files of type *.zip that reside in that folder. And there are other options for creating other transfers from different file types. Now we need to create a target, or we can reuse existing targets. We want something related to SOA, so let's filter here using search to find what we want, which is a SOA target. Click and drag into the target pane or click Add Target and select it from the list. It now shows up in transfers. This is going to a SOA composite and BPL process. Here we can specify delivery preferences for each transfer. We can always send a reference to the file if the file data is too large. The advantage to sending a reference instead of attaching a large payload is to avoid storing all of the BPL process data in the database. Instead, just specify sending a reference if the maximum size is greater than 1 megabyte. If it's less than 1 megabyte, go ahead and send the entire file. We will choose file for the reference type. Now we can add a schedule. Oracle incorporated the enterprise scheduler that ships with 12C into the managed file transfer product, so you don't need to install a separate scheduler. We can choose to only invoke SOA target in afternoons or early evenings. We can specify frequency, such as daily, and set a time to begin, such as start at noon. These transfers sit in the MFT repository in an active scheduled process. We can also specify an end date and duration. This is an enhancement to scheduler that we added for MFT. We can remove dates, such as holidays, and we can add them back. So there are lots of options. We need to set the pre-processing actions so the files transferred are encrypted. We need to set the process to decompress the file and then select the decrypt option and add it to the list. Now select a decryption alias that's configured in the backend system. Click OK and the options appear. Next, we can go back and add another target type. Go into the filter string and look for file. The use case for choosing another target type is for archiving by putting it in a file system outside of the MFT repository. We can drag and drop it to target or create a new target. We can reuse existing file targets by just creating a new subdirectory for the file target. This will overwrite the old location with the new location. Now we will add a post-processing action. Click Add and select Post-Transfer Notification. Look at the parameters. It gives an email notification and can apply to all file types. We can choose to filter the file size. This notification lets us know when larger files have been submitted. We can configure the email message with an email template. For instance, the email can have the header information, an email body, and more information. Once everything is set up in the parameter section, click Deploy in the top right corner. The deployment mechanism knows what artifacts are new, and it tells us what will not be redeployed. Click Deploy, and we get a message saying it was successful. The last thing is to look for the bulk order transfer, and we can use search to find it. So here is the transfer. Select it and click Show Deployment Details. The information shows the last deployed current status, the referring targets, the sources, and more information. This is good information from the runtime. So for the most part in MFT, we have separated design from monitoring, but this is a case where design has visibility into the runtime system. So that's how you work with the MFT design tool. See our other MFT demos for more information.